Hi guys, it's Michaela here, and I'm in so much pain right now. I just started soccer preseason, and I've been trying to do my back to school series, and I really kind of couldn't because of preseason. But I just filmed one just because I got up early enough today to do one. Even though right now my legs just feel like they hate me because they're so sore. And they are so sore and it hurts so much. But anyway, today I am going to show you how to, jazz up a backpack because I had bought this lime green backpack. It was for $35, so awesome. And I wanted to do something with it because I didn't want it to just seem plain. In the video, you will see me attempt to try and stencil on here, but I ended up messing it up. So I just kind of took the two basically, I don't know what to call it, most pigmented colors, and I basically tried to thin out the paint as much as I could, and then took the two pigmented colors and put them on there, and I did some studding and some flower work. And that's basically the video for today because, when you go back to school, everything is so boring and you don't like it and you just want to do something new. So I just thought, hey, why don't you just do your own backpack? And I just really hope you guys enjoy this video. Please like this video, favorite, subscribe, and I just thank you for taking the time to watch this. I'm sorry I look like this. It's because literally probably right after I film this, I'm going to have to get ready for preseason and I can't move. So we're gonna try and see. All right, but just thank you again for watching this video and I hope you enjoy. Bye. First off, you'll need paint, sponges, studs, stencils, and most importantly, your backpack. So first of all, you're gonna take a plate and you're gonna take your paints. I just chose two colors, a neon orange and a green. And I then took a stencil and I took some tape just to keep the stencil sturdy because you can really mess up if you don't have anything holding your stencil down. So it's really good to have tape. Now what you're going to do is you're going to start grabbing your sponges and dipping it in your paint and stenciling it on. For the first stencil, I just chose green for the leaves, orange for one of the flowers, blue for the small little flower, and purple for the other. One touch, one kiss, one chick that I can't resist. And I'm like, yeah. So after you have let it dry for some, you're gonna go and grab your studs. And what I decided to do was basically put it along the upper part of the backpack. And you may be wondering why the pocket is different. It's because I moved and the paint smudged under, so it just looked like a huge blob. So I just decided to take my two most pigmented colors, the blue and the purple, and just basically cover that front pocket. But now, as you see, I'm just putting on the studs all around and pressing them in with just anything that I had. I didn't have a knife, I just had one of these sponge bottoms. But you can just use whatever to push in the studs. I'm just going back and making sure that the prongs of the studs are really pressed in so that they don't fall out or poke me when I happen to unzip my backpack. And now I am going to be basically doing the same thing, but just with the front pockets, and the part that covers the zipper, just so, I don't know, it can just look nicer. And I basically do the same steps that I did for the top of the backpack. I'm sorry my voice is so monotone. It's just because I've been in a lot of pain because of preseason soccer, so we're starting to work out and my muscles are so sore, but I promise I'll be better in my next tutorial. Once you have finished, you're now done with your backpack. Hope you enjoy.